greatest form of control is where you think you're free when you're being fundamentally manipulated and dictated. One form of dictatorship is being in a prison cell and you can see the bars and touch it. The other one is sitting in a prison cell but you can't see the bar, you think you're free. What the human race is suffering from is mass hypnosis. Supremacy. I am undesired energy, sent friendly, sent empty. Show the Prince of Peace no clemency. Give him an extremity of insensitivity. That is kin and ministry, witnesses in the assembly. I just love sufferance. I'm destructive, unproductive, cussed, not much substance. Luggage above judgment, unaware of any air of doubt. Where it counts, I'm a fair amount of paramount. I embody a monopoly of ungodly. The hobby robbed me of my comic camaraderie. My apology.
Like, yo, there's this Puerto Rican kid who makes crazy beats. He's looking for MCs. So we got introduced. Shortly after that, I bumped into a friend of Juss's who was like, yo, my man Rhymes. So then we met around the same time that Stupid and I met. So I was like, yo, let's go over to this brother's house and see what's what. So that's what we did. And that's how it started. That was 18 years ago. Yeah, man.
Yeah.
I mean, I would say it's just who we are, you know, like, I really didn't realize that, you know what I mean, most people didn't have a passion in life, you know what I mean? Like, I thought everyone liked rap as much as I did, you know what I'm saying? Like, but like, nah, no one really even cared. It was more of like I just felt like a driving force pulling me towards it, you know? Like, I would get tapes my parents would hate. Like, it was just something I did, you know? It was just all about, like, the music for me, you know?
We never knew anything else. I think that's the thing with why we're still together. We never knew anything else. We're not engineers, we don't know how to do anything.
I never had an affinity for anything else besides making raps and music. You know?
And Juss summed it up perfectly. I always thought everyone was as passionate as us. Then other people were like, I'm so jealous, like, y'all are so passionate about something, and I'm not. I'm like, huh? I had the assumption that everyone was passionate about something. But they say that people meet each other for a reason.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, the person that introduced us, we don't even know him anymore.
right.
So it's like, yo, something intervened there, you know, whether it's divine intervention, dumb luck, whatever you want to call it. Right. We're still together. That's my brother for life. Because we think the same about a lot.
Yeah. Even before the rapping, like, Paz was in the boxing and, like, I was the kid at the basketball court till the lights went out. You know what I'm saying? Like, we were always,
we're
like,
just driven people.
Yeah, man. We were doing what we wanted to do, you know?
Just kind of kept you on the straight and narrow too, I suppose.
Absolutely. We never really got caught up in, like, we had major label offer deals when we were really young kids that, you know, maybe me and Juss would have taken. Stoop was, you know, a few years older than us. You know, a couple major labels were interested in us throughout our career, and I don't know where we'd be at if we would have signed them. We might be stuck in limbo somewhere. We decided to go for Dolo. You know what I mean? We did our first demos. He was passing them out in high school. I was passing them out in high school. We was battling people. Like, small things made us think we were on the right road. I don't know if, you know, in the UK or Europe, y'all got On The Go magazine. On The Go was huge for us because it was graffiti and hip hop, and it was based out of Philly, which was amazing for us. And they, like, reviewed our demo. And we were 14 or 15 years old. And it was a good review. Now, look, just a little review this big doesn't mean a lot to a lot of people. But to us, that's all we cared about. We were like, yo, all right.
Let's go.
We're doing something right.
And the 50 always next to me like Lloyd Banks. Impolite motherfucker, I avoid thanks. Don't be the next motherfucker that my boy shanks. I'm the knockout king and that's with Dalroy. For your shit talking rappers, here's an Altoid. Shouldn't open your mouth, boy. Here's some beef for you vegetarians with Alstoy. You fucking with a kamikaze. I'm just killing myself to live, I promise, Ozzy. I ain't catching anything besides a body. You could catch me on Allegheny with Maserati. You could catch me in Canarsie with Bill. I'm a black Tibetan magic, see my sorcery kill. Yo, when it gets an army, how you forced to repel?
Oh, I mean, huge, tremendous. I mean, tremendously huge. You know, the things Chuck was saying. Our generation that's sitting here to hear Chuck saying what he was saying, just as a black man, to hear that, you know, sort of gave a lot of people some power.
Yeah.
It's inspiring, but the thing that people never really understood, and again, this more applies to me. I'm not speaking, you know, I'm Sicilian, so. Doesn't apply to everyone, but like with me, I was like, this is poor people music. It's urban poor people music. There's Italians in the projects, Puerto Ricans in the projects, blacks in the projects, Chinos in the project. So that's how me and Just were. Oh, you was poor? Oh, I was poor too. Oh, your dad wasn't around? Oh, my dad was dead too. So you start saying these things to where you connect on so many levels. And I understood all that shit Chuck was talking about. Not necessarily from the stance of a black man, because obviously I'm not one. But fight the power and fuck you and don't oppression. Yeah. I understood all that.
I mean, as being, I guess, A Nation of Millions came out, like, that was probably one of the first tapes I had. Someone dubbed it for me. I had Strictly Business EPMD on the other side of it, you know what I mean? And yo, like, but it was like, the first mention of Farrakhan was on that, was like, I'd heard from Chuck D, you know what I mean? Like, that was real. Like, no one else was saying nothing like that. You weren't getting that kind of knowledge from school. You weren't getting it nowhere, like, except from like, Public Enemy, you know what I mean? And Fight the Power is, like, the strongest saying ever, you know
still,
what I mean?
People
like,
still use that slang today. You have a slang from a rap record that was on a soundtrack of a film that didn't really do that well. I mean, we all know, you know, Do the Right Thing, because that's our generation, but it didn't make $100 million. But people will still say Fight the Power in slang. You know what I'm saying? Like, they don't even listen to rap. That's slang, Fight the Power.
It's a cult movie, though.
It is, and it created something, and it's like, then there were other people, like Paris. You know, we were listening to Paris in the car today. You know, talking about, you know what I'm saying, issues. You had Lakem Shabazz, Lord Shafiq. You know, these are people that influenced our
Tribe,
all the native tongues, De La. Brand New. You know, King Sun. You know, these are dudes that we were like, yo, this shit is still hard. Here's what it is, and we still live by this credo. You don't have to be soft to be intellectual. That's what we learned from Public Enemy and the Bomb Squad. Those records are hard as shit. Chuck's going in, like, ma! And that shit will make you want to wild out. But still, it's still brain food. Somewhere along the... I'm sorry, go ahead.
The Bomb Squad is creating those incredible...
Right, the Shockley brothers and stuff like that. Somewhere along the line... I don't know how you say it. Somewhere along the line, it got blurred and people started associating like intellectual shit with being soft. I don't like that shit. It's like, why? You know, X-Clan was hard.
Oh yeah.
X-Clan was, that shit was hard, you know?
African stuff.
Absolutely. Amazing record.
I loved X-Clan.
Brother Jay is one of the most underrated rappers to ever live.
You motherfuckers haven't even left the block yet. You the bitch, you the hoe, here's a progress. You wanna try to box with guys? There's no contest. Don't keep on thinking this shit is sweet. I'ma start a stand soon, put you under the Middle East. You got it fucked up, homie, I've been a beast. Reptilian tongue, and my skin is deep. Rumor has it, they say I'm thrown off. To the lifters everywhere, we it's not the cast of a death mask. It's that water in a red glass. Why I thought you never asked, it's a legend ass. There's a method to the mad, it's directing fast. Disconnected from the gap, it's a second class. I have left the trail of death, checks in the mail. Heads or tails that prevails, never fails. I will never get the rails, that ship is sailed. I will never get the hell, that ship has sailed. Over fine mastermind after cast and kind. In a gunshot panorama.
J
just working with people I've been wanting to work with for years. Lord Finesse, DJ Muggs, Little Fame from MOP, Madlib, Paul Wall, Eclipse, my brothers R.A. the Rugged Man, L. Bill. Trying to think of everyone. I work with a lot of people on the record. Just an extension of what we already do, you know? Just trying to do that hard body shit, but enlighten people at the same time, really, you know? That's the agenda. You gotta spoon feed them, you know? Too heavily, you gotta give them their medicine and applesauce. Probably still does. It starts becoming less of my responsibility, and more when I know that I delivered something. It's like a mailman delivering a package. If he delivered the package and the person never got it or opened it, it's not really the mailman's fault. The person has to open it and receive the information that was delivered to them. It's out of my hands. I mean, you know, I don't wish it to be that way. I deliver it. If you open it up. It's a little gift in there for you. It's a little present in my record if you open it up.
Like we all know what's going down. Know what's saying, know what happened to the home of the brave. These motherfuckers ain't controlling us now. And no one's talking about how they made us modern day slaves.
Come on.
And everybody's just walking around head in the clouds. We wanna wake until we're dead in the grave. But then it's too late, we need to be ready to raise up. Welcome to the end of days.
Raise up.
Welcome to the end of days.
Raise up. Welcome to the end of days.
Raise up.
Welcome to the end of days.
Raise up.
Raise up. Raise up. Raise up. Raise up. Fight the motherfucking power.
Keep your fist up, y'all. Keep your fist up.